Hello friends, in this video I will be explaining you or I will be helping you with the term Nagle's algorithm. Remember one thing, I am just giving you the introduction of Nagle's algorithm in this video. So if you want a detailed video on Nagle's algorithm, you may comment down and I will make a video on it as soon as possible. So let's start. So small 4 byte packets flow in a network are called as teeny grams. So small packets or packets around 4 bytes of data that are being sent in a network are called as teeny grams. These teeny grams add to congestion on WAN. What is WAN? If you don't know, it is wide area network, or you can say a network that exists between different countries and maybe may exist between different continents also. So it is very wide in range, very big in range. So if there are too many tiny grams data that is being sent in a wide area network, it may add to congestion. Why? So I will explain you, like, if there is a very big wide area network is very big, let's consider this as network. So teeny grams are like this, and in wide area network, very large amount of data needs to be sent. So like these teeny grams are like small dots in that. So if a large amount of data needs to be shared, these teeny grams will cause congestion, or you can say blockage, due to which this big or large packet won't be sent at a very fast speed. So that is like congestion only. That's why teeny grams cause congestion in WAN. But in case of LANs, they are not worry. So most LANs are not congested because teeny grams are not a problem on LANs. Why? So because LANs generally consist of 4 or 5 users. LAN is very small, so it does not stay much. It does not stay much busy. So and the users are just normal users only, and the data generally sended is not heavy. So that's why these teeny grams are just okay and does not cause congestion. But in case of WAN, very large amount of data is being shared, and if lots of teeny grams will be there, then it may cause blockage to those large amount of data. So to solve the problem of congestion in WAN, Nagle's algorithm is used. So you can use it for the introduction of Nagle's algorithm, why we use Nagle's algorithm in computer networks. So Nagle's algorithm says that TCP connection has outstanding data that has not yet been acknowledged. Small segment cannot be sent until the outstanding data is acknowledged. What it says is, I will give you a good example. Like if you have used a mobile operator, many of the mobile app operator gives you a balance of, or you can say loan of 15 to 20 credits, right? Many of you must have used also. Like if you have a zero balance in your mobile phone, or and you are having a prepaid phone, then many of the mobile companies give you 15 to 20 credits so that you can use it. And after that, you need to call someone, then you can't until you pay these credit, or when you recharge next, then these 15 to 20 credits will be detected, or you can treat it as a loan. So this is like that only. So Nagle's algorithm says that when some amount of data has been sent to the receiver, like I need a blank space. Yeah, this is the blank space. So when some amount of data has been sent from sender to receiver like this, now till the time the sender does not receive the acknowledgement, more data is not being sent. In spite of that, it is accumulated in the TCP layer or TCP connection, and later on it is sended as a segment instead of sending it as a tiny grams. So that will not cause congestion in WAN, because tiny grams cause congestion in WAN. So this is how with the help of Nagle's algorithm, the congestion is avoided in WAN due to tiny grams. So this you can use it for your notes. So I already explained you in practical way. So instead, small amount of data are collected by TCP and send it in a single segment when acknowledgement arrives. As I told you, when acknowledgement comes, the data that has been collected in the TCP layer is sent in a segment that is contained in the WAN connection, and after it reaches the destination, it may be divided into small tiny grams, and then may be sent to their final destination. So the faster the acknowledgement comes back, the faster the data is sent. But on a slow WAN, where it is desired to reduce the number of teeny grams, fewer segments are sent. So Nagle's algorithm is widely used by TCP implementation. So to deal with congestion, the small tiny grams is sent with the help of one single segments, and many if there are many tiny grams, these are divided into small segments, or you can say bigger segments as compared to tiny grams, and then send it in WAN so that they don't cause congestion in network. And this is how congestion is treated in WAN. So another problem on TCP performance is silly window syndrome. What it actually is, I will just tell you in short. So like whenever in a network a sender sends a big packet, large packet to the receiver, now what there is a window that this amount of data can be sent, like 5 Mbps data can be sent, that is 5 MB can be sent, right? So whenever it is sent at receiver's end, sometimes the receiver's translator is 1 byte at a time. So to treat 1 byte at a time, it will take lots of computing, right? So slowly the window size will reduce because the amount of data being accumulated in the buffer is increasing. So a time will reach there when this buffer becomes full, because it is treating 1 byte at a time. It will analyze 1 byte at a time, and then it will send, then again it will take 1 byte, then again it will do, and again it will send. It will not treat the whole data as whole, and it will just treat 1 byte at a time. So that is the negative thing. That's why the data will be accumulated in a buffer if the sending data is at much higher rate, and one time will come when the buffer has become full and more data cannot be sended, so ultimately resulting in congestion and no acknowledgement could be sended from receiver's end due to this congestion. So to avoid this, the Nagle's algorithm is used in a similar way as it is used in WAN. So this was all about the introduction to Nagle's algorithm. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.